manager is probably the, you know, outside of your kind of key people in the record company are probably the most important people in your career as your manager, right? And it's hard to find the right one. So I suppose sometimes it does interfere to some degree, but you just have to grin and bear it, you know?
I think we're still kind of pursuing that, the right happy amalgamation to get it the right for us,
We have an oldie for you from Worlds Away.
Oh, but a goodie.
Yeah?
Great.
Okay, let's take a look at it. This is Strange Advance, and She Controls Me on Much Music.
First started, we were at Little Mountain, and it had like old Neve consoles. This is an SSL, it's an automated board, but back when we started, for complicated mixes, we would have like four or five guys all on the console. Okay, your job is to, you know, at this point in time, you pull those down by 10 dB, and your job is to push these things up. And so we would be doing this complicated ballet, and people, you know, everyone trying to do their bit. Did you get it? Did you get it? It's like, oh shit, I forgot to mute this track or whatever, or run it back from the beginning. And it was definitely a community effort, and it was a very fun, lots of fun times. It all started when I put an ad in the Vancouver Sun looking for a singer. Somebody actually sent me a copy of the ad the other day. Wanted, uninhibited singer to join the Glitter Brigade. And Daryl answered the ad. And that was the start of our partnership. And we formed a band called Slan. And it was like our version of a top 40 act. A cover band, you know, except all the material that we were covering was obscure things that nobody in Vancouver had ever heard before, you know, because we were, you know, sort of on the cutting edge, you would say, of the British pop scene and stuff. So our big crowd-pleasing opening number was Watcher of the Skies by Genesis, which was a pretty epic number. And Daryl had black light makeup on his eyes, so you know the black light would shine and all you would see is this glowing pair of eyes on stage, and most people did not get it, and as a result we were fired more times than I'd like to count, but that was the beginning of it, and from Slan, you know, we evolved into Strange Advance.
Strange Advance.
The sound of Strange Advance, a big part of the sound came from the fact that I was not a schooled musician. I was a drummer who had music in his head and I had no idea how to get it out. I didn't know about chord structure. I didn't know, you know, I've never played, picked up a guitar and, you know, strummed through all the pop songs of the moment. So I developed my own sort of sound and style, and Strange Advance is what came of it. The biggest thrill I ever got was having Alan Holdsworth come into the studio in Toronto and play on a couple of our tracks. And I was just looking at the Toronto newspaper and saw that he was playing in town that night. So I had our manager call his manager and Alan agreed to come to the studio after his gig. So he showed up and played some phenomenal Alan Holdsworth guitar as only he can, and I can remember standing near the console just listening to him playing, and the tears were, you know, forming. It was like, I just can't believe that he's playing on something that I've written. It was phenomenal. Randy Bachman, of course, a Canadian legend, and and he lived in White Rock, and a friend of mine worked for him and invited me down to his studio, and I met Randy, and I was in Toronto, and Randy was here, and I called my friend and said, any chance you could get Randy to, you know, put a solo down on this song? At that time, I was working with an Akai 1214, which is like basically a combination mixer and recorder that used like beta tape to record on. So you could record 12 tracks on that. And fortunately, my friend in Vancouver also had one. So he recorded Randy on his and then sent me the tape. And so we were all set.
This is the brand new LP called 2WO. Do you want to explain the title to us?
Uh-oh.
Somebody has to.
Uh-oh.
Well, that numeral 2 is all supposed to be written in sand. And
yes.
W-O has no, it's just sort of like we replaced the numeral, the T in 2 with a numeral 2. It's just 2.
Oh.
So it's not 2-O. I know.
It's so simple
and
that
it has
I didn't
hurt.
Even.
Frequently hurts when people, 2-W-O, yeah. So
when you sign a record deal, it's a pretty momentous occasion. And as a matter of fact, for the first like 6 months at least, both Daryl and I suffered from imposter syndrome. You know, we thought, oh, there's been a mistake. You know, they thought they were signing this band, but they signed us by accident. It's like, no, there's something wrong in the universe, you know. So we got over that and worked in the studio Little Mountain for the most part with Bruce Fairburn, our producer. And it was just being in the room with him and learning all his techniques and watching how things were done and observing. And so it's like slowly you feel like you're okay, I'm more comfortable in that world. Yeah, it was just a gradual process. And at the root of it though, the whole time it was the music. That's the driving force, you know, for Strange Advance. You know, Daryl and I weren't interested in, you know, sort of the glamorous side of things, you know, sex, drugs, rock and roll. The sex and the drugs, it's like, no, it's the rock and roll, it's the music that we were into.
Mayor Art Eggleton, hello.
Hello, how are you today?
Fine, we grabbed you and pulled you over here because if this band was, from Vancouver, we wouldn't.
You would have
need you.
But they're from Toronto.
That's right.
Great.
We figured it was appropriate. Strange Advance, why don't you just introduce the videos? And
okay, Strange Advance from Toronto are now going to give you Love Becomes Electric, We Run, She Controls Me, and Love Games.
On Much Music and Stereo.
On Much Music and Stereo.
There you go.
Thank you, sir.
Coming into the studio today, I heard on the radio that it's been 30 years since Kurt Cobain passed away. 30 years. And Kurt Cobain was responsible, and Nirvana were responsible, and their success were responsible for a lot of people, you know, suddenly doing like a 180. You know, a lot of bands in the synth pop style, a lot of like 80s had a lot of sort of hair metal kind of bands. And suddenly they were all made redundant. You know, it was like, it's a whole new vibe now. You know, like the whole Seattle grunge scene, you know, changed the focus of the public. Through that time period, you know, musical tastes had changed so radically. It seemed like the right thing to do would be take care of the home front first and not worry too much about the music. And so I just took time off and what do you know, 30 years later, I'm back. Yeah, it was really what happened was David Bowie passed away.
Well, it's just after 7 o'clock, and our main news this morning are the reports that David Bowie has died peacefully in his sleep at his home in New York.
Daryl and I had always talked about putting the band back out there, getting back into the music, and but it was just talk. And then when Bowie passed away, it suddenly became real, you know, because it's like, okay, he's whatever, 5 or 10 years older than us. So, you know, we're next. You know, if we were ever going to do it, this would be the time. So I started the process, and it took, you know, a number of years to actually reach fruition. But finally, I have a band, and also the other aspect is, I've had a chance to revisit the world of Strange Advance, and there were things that, you know, that I thought could have been better in the band, you know, back in the day. So this was like, oh, I've got another shot at bat here. You know, I can do what I envisioned doing all those years ago, and that's all coming to pass. So I'm getting an even better experience of Strange Advance now than I did back in its heyday. She can take you places where you thought you'd never go. Ooh, she controls me. She can teach you things you never thought you'd ever know. Ooh, she controls me. My only expectation is to, you know, play in front of as many people as we can. When we started, we didn't tour after the first album. We toured after the second and the third album, but and then that was it. We're into the 90s, and you know, okay, let's pull the plug on this. And but we didn't actually play that many times. I would guess probably in the 80s we only played like maybe 30 or 40 concerts. You know, so this time, we're trying to satisfy people's desire to actually get a chance to see the band that they liked enough to buy their records, you know, back in the day. So right now, we're just building momentum, trying to cover as much of the country as we can.
Daryl and Drew, some plans. You've got some touring coming up and a few other things. What's in the works?
Well, we're basically doing a bunch of Eastern dates right now. And we finally get to see, you know, a good chunk of the country we've never seen before, off to Prince Edward Island and
it's
Newfoundland.
Very beautiful out there,
yeah,
too.
Yeah, I'm looking forward to
beautiful.
It.
Exceptionally beautiful. We'll get to see a whole other ocean. We heard there's another one on the other side of the country.
Yeah, there is. We've never seen
this
other ocean, no.
You can go swimming at Cabot Beach. Mm.
Yeah, sounds good.
But I've really, right now, it's just having the band, getting the chance to revisit the old tunes and revisit or a visit for the first time those fans in far off places in Canada. One thing I learned as time went on was there's a point in time when you're a youngster, you're very malleable and open to suggestion, and you're listening to the radio and you find your niche or whatever. Your whatever particular genre of music you're into, and you devote yourself to that, and that stays with you, you know, the rest of your life. 14-year-olds, you know, 18-year-olds, 22-year-olds, you know, coming to our shows back in the 80s. Well, now those people have such fond memories of the music that they grew up loving, that they're all coming to the shows now, and it's fascinating to get to see, you know, there used to be an ocean of teenagers out there, and now it's like an ocean of, you know, white hair and...
So look, this band comes out of Vancouver. We used to play the out of them on Much Music. Songs like We Run, Home of the Brave, and of course, She Controls Me, and the classic, my favorite of all time, Worlds Away. So, if they're ready, you guys cool? Are you guys cool? Ladies and gentlemen, all the way from Vancouver, British Columbia, my friends and yours musically, Burlington at the Sound of Music Festival, make a hell of a lot of noise for Strange Advance.
There's so many different angles you can take, and we could blather for hours. You know, it's such a fun topic, and it's led to the opportunity to meet all sorts of people you never thought you'd, you know, be sitting around talking to. And you know, getting to meet your musical heroes and things. And it's, there's so many great aspects to life in the music business, as long as you have a bit of talent and a lot of luck.